Today we are going to discuss the invariance of Poisson brackets under canonical transformations. Actually, in previous lectures we have seen the definition of Poisson bracket, and along with the definition of Poisson bracket we have also discussed the important properties of this Poisson bracket. Now, using those ideas, we will be able to see that this Poisson bracket remains same when we follow the canonical transformation. You have studied this canonical transformation in previous lecture in very detail, and you know that the canonical transformation is simply the transformation of phase space. And during this transformation, we simply transform the old set of coordinates denoted by the symbol small q and small p into the new set of coordinates, that is capital Q and capital P. So when you say invariance of the Poisson bracket of two dynamical variables, let us say u and v, it means the Poisson bracket of the dynamical variable u and v under canonical transformation means what? It means the value of the Poisson bracket of dynamical variable u and v with respect to a small q and a small p is same as that of the value of Poisson bracket of these two dynamical variables u and v with respect to the new set of coordinates capital Q and capital P. In fact, the equivalence ensures the equality in the value, not in the form. When you say that not in the form, it means that U and V do not necessarily have the same form in terms of the two set of coordinates, that is small q small p and capital Q capital P. So invariance means the value of the Poisson bracket of dynamical variables u and v remains same when we use either the old set of coordinates small q small p or the new set of coordinates capital Q and capital P. So we have to prove that the Poisson bracket of u and v with respect to a small q small p will be same as that of the Poisson bracket of u and v with respect to capital Q and capital P. We have to show this. When this result will hold, we will say that the Poisson bracket remains invariant under canonical transformation. So for this, let us start to find the value of this bracket with respect to the new set of coordinates. And so let us start to find it. So Poisson bracket of U and V with respect to capital Q capital P. You know from the definition of Poisson bracket how we will define it. So from the defining equation you can say this is summation over I del U by del QI times del V by del PI del V by del PI minus del U by del PI times del V by del QI. You know this is just definition of Poisson bracket. Now since any of the dynamical variable, let us say V, is actually a function of the coordinates small q and small p. This is also actually a function of capital Q and capital P. Similarly, U is also a function of small q and small p. And therefore, taking this fact under account, you can write this RHS of this equation in this way, as I am writing here. You can see that Poisson bracket of U and V with respect to capital Q capital P. This is summation over I and J. I and J. And del U by del QI times. Now this del V by del PI. Since V is a function of a small q and a small p, so we can write this del V by del PI by the rule of partial differentiation in this way. This can be written as del V by del QJ. So I have taken here the limits of this summation J, because I am writing here the coordinate Q as QJ. Del V by del QJ times del QJ by this del PI. Del PI. And plus del V by del PJ times del PJ by del, again this del PI, because finally we have to differentiate with respect to PI. So instead of this del V by del PI, I have written this, you can see. And now minus del U by del PI, write this factor at edge, del U by del PI. And instead of this del V by del QI, we will again follow the rule of partial differentiation like this. We can write this as del V by del V by del QJ times del QJ by finally del QI. Del QI and plus del V by del PJ times del PJ by del QI. Finally, you have to differentiate with respect to QI. QI. So del PJ by del QI. Now, associate the similar terms in RHS, you can see. Here there is del V by del QJ, and in second term also here there is del V by del QJ. So associate these two terms, and after associating these two terms, you can take this del V by del QJ as a common factor. So when we will take del V by del QJ as a common factor and combine the first term of first term in this RHS and this first term in the second bracket, then what will be your result, you can see. So Poisson bracket of U and V with respect to capital Q capital P, you can write summation over J and del V by del QJ. As I have told you, you can see del V by this del QJ will be taken as a common factor. Del V by del QJ. And in the first term, you can see there will be del U by del QI times del QJ by del PI. Del U by del QI times del QJ by del PI. Del QJ by del PI. And now see this term. Here when you will take del V by del QJ as a common factor, the remaining factors are del U by del PI times del QJ by del QI. So this will be minus del u by del pi times del qj by del qi, del qj by qj by del qi. Yes. And now see this term. In this term, we will take this del v by del pj as a common factor. See here, del v by del pj as a common factor. So, plus there will be del v by del pj as a common factor. And the remaining terms you can see, here there will be del u by del qi times del pj by del pi. See here. So this is del u by del qi times del pj by del pi and minus. Now see this term. We have taken this del v by del pj as a common factor. So the remaining terms are del u by del pi times del pj by del qi. So this will be minus del u by del pi times del pj by del qi. Yes. Del v by del p. One thing there should be here. Actually, there should be a sign of summation here. Summation over I. Mark this. Summation over I. Now, see this factor. Summation over I del u by del qi times del qj by del pi minus del u by del pi times del qj by del qi. What is this? Can you say? You can easily recognize this is nothing. This is simply the Poisson bracket of the variables u and qj with respect to capital Q and capital P. And similarly, summation over I del u by del qi times del pj by del pi minus del u by del pi times del pj by del qi. This is the Poisson bracket of variables u and pj with respect to the new set of coordinates capital Q and capital P. So, writing in terms of the Poisson bracket, this expression can be written as summation over j del v by del qj and instead of this bracketed term you will write this is nothing, this is simply the Poisson bracket of the variable u and qj with respect to capital Q capital P and plus. Now see this factor, this is actually the Poisson bracket of u and pj, so we can write this is del v by del pj times Poisson bracket of u and pj with respect to capital Q capital P. And say this is your equation 1. Now we will simply evaluate these two Poisson brackets, that is Poisson bracket of u and qj and Poisson bracket of u and pj. We will now evaluate. So from the property of Poisson bracket, you have seen actually the Poisson bracket is not commutative when we just reverse the order. the sign of the bracket it get reversed. So now our aim is to evaluate these two brackets. So Poisson bracket of U and QJ with respect to this capital Q capital P. From the property of Poisson bracket, you know this is equal to minus Poisson bracket of QJ and U on the same base, that is Q and P. Now this Poisson bracket of Q and U can be evaluated simply by using the equation number 1. As you can see here, the Poisson bracket of U and V with respect to capital Q capital P is equal to this much. So using this equation, we can find the value of the Poisson bracket in this RHS of this equation. And for this, you can see at the place of U here, there is QJ, and at the place of V, there is U. So simply QJ will be replaced. QJ will be replaced by U, and U will be replaced by V. So you can say we can write the Poisson bracket of QJ and U simply by putting QJ, see here is QJ and here is U, QJ for U and U for V, you can compare. So taking this fact under account, you can now write the expression for this Poisson bracket of QJ on and U with the help of this equation 1. So see this equivalence and write the expression. Therefore, we can say that Poisson bracket of U and QJ is equal to minus Poisson bracket of QJ and U. Here actually this is with respect to Q and P. And taking this fact into account, we will write QJ instead of U and U for V, and we will use the equation 1. So you can see what will be the expression on this basis. We can write, change the index here. I am writing here summation over minus is due to this minus sign, summation over K, and you can see here is actually del V by del QJ. But we will write U for V, you can see here. So instead of V in this equation 1, in this term, we will write now U. And instead of this subscript J, I have written here K. So this will be del U by del QK. I have changed the index, del QK. And there is Poisson bracket of U and QJ, and you can see U will be replaced by QJ, and this QJ will be replaced actually by V. And this QJ will be replaced by QK. So this is Poisson bracket of QJ and QK, you can see, on the basis Q and P. And plus, now see the second term, there is del V by del PJ, but instead of V here, you can see, we will write U. We have to write U for V. So this will be del U by del PJ, but J subscript has been replaced by K, so this is del PK. Del PK. And Poisson bracket of U and PJ, U and PJ, and for U we have to write QJ, so write here QJ. And there is PJ, and for the J we will now write K, so this is PK on the basis Q and P. Now, as you know, you have seen in the property of Poisson bracket that the Poisson bracket of this QJ and QK is equal to 0. This is equal to 0. So the first term in the RHS of the above equation will vanish, and therefore you can write the Poisson bracket of U and QJ with respect to capital Q capital P, this will be minus summation over K, and this bracket is 0, so the first term is 0, and plus the second term is this much, so this is del U by del PK. And again, you have seen in when we have discussed the property of Poisson bracket, that Poisson bracket of QJ and PK, QJ and PK on the basis capital Q and capital P, this is actually equal to Kronecker delta JK. You have seen this thing in the previous lecture. So instead of this Poisson bracket of QJ and PK, we will write the Kronecker delta JK. Kronecker delta JK. And so this is simply minus summation over K del U by del PK times Kronecker delta JK. Delta JK. Now you know when J is equal to K, then this Kronecker delta JK will be equal to 1. And this Kronecker delta will be 0 if J is not equal to K. So taking J equal to K, when you will take J equal to K, then this term will become fixed and there will be no sign of summation. And so then this Kronecker delta will be equal to 1. So you can write this expression as, therefore, Poisson bracket of U and QJ at the base Q and P, this will be equal to minus del U by del PJ. See here, I have taken actually J equal to K, and then this subscript K has been replaced by J, and this Kronecker delta becomes 1. So in this way, you can see we have obtained that the Poisson bracket of U and QJ with respect to capital Q capital P, this is minus del U by del PJ. So you can see we have obtained this Poisson bracket of equation number 1. In fact, in a similar manner, you can also obtain the value of this Poisson bracket of U and Pj. And this is just a homework for you. On the same line, on the same by the same process, you can you can follow the step which I have just discussed and obtain this value. So I am not going to find the value of this Poisson bracket, and this is I have left it just for your homework. So I am writing here similarly. Similarly, Poisson bracket of U and Pj. U and Pj with respect to capital Q, capital P. When actually you will follow the same step and find the value of this Poisson bracket, you can see you will get the value del U by del Qj. Del U by del Qj. And say this is equation 3. Now, after getting the value of these two Poisson brackets, we will simply substitute the values of these brackets in the equation number 1. So, using equations 2 and 3 in equation 1. See here, what is your equation 1? You can see this is in fact Poisson bracket of U and V with respect to capital Q, capital P. You can see here. And we have obtained the value of this Poisson bracket and this Poisson bracket. So let us put the value of those two Poisson bracket here. So when you will put, you can see there will be del V by del Qj times this much and plus del V by del Pj times this much. So after putting the values of these two Poisson brackets in this equation 1, we will get Poisson bracket of U and V with respect to capital Q, capital P. This will be summation over j. And in the first term, you can see here, there is del V by del Qj. And this Poisson bracket you have obtained, this is minus del U by del Pj. So first term will be negative. So I have written here minus sign. This is minus del V by del Qj times del U by del Pj. And plus, in the second term, you can see there is del V by del Pj times this much. And this Poisson bracket is simply del U by del Qj. So now write the second term. This will be del V by del Pj times del U by del Qj. Now arrange the terms in the RHS of this equation. You can write this equation like this. This is del U by del Qj times del V by del Pj minus del U by del Pj times del V by del Qj. You can write. Now, see the expression in RHS. Can you say what is this? Definitely you can say. As you have studied the definition of Poisson bracket of two dynamical variables, and you can see This is nothing. This is simply the Poisson bracket of the dynamical variables u and v, but with respect to a small q and a small p. So you can write this expression as this is simply the Poisson bracket of u and v with respect to a small q, a small p. So finally, you can see that this Poisson bracket with respect to capital Q, capital P is equal to the Poisson bracket of the same dynamical variables with respect to a small q and a small p. So therefore, finally we get Poisson bracket of u and v with respect to the new variables capital Q, capital P equal to Poisson bracket of u and v with respect to the old set of coordinates. So the result which we have to prove, you can see it is proved here. So what this result shows? This result shows that actually the Poisson brackets does not change, it remains invariant under canonical transformation. And the value of the Poisson bracket with respect to the old set of coordinates, that is a small q, small p, and its value with respect to the new set of coordinates, that is capital Q, capital P, remains same. And that's why it is not needed to write these subscripts, that is capital Q, capital P, or a small q, small p, after the bracket. There is no need. Because when you write capital Q, capital P, or small q, small p, value remains same. So what is the need to write this? So there is no need to write this subscript capital Q or capital P, or small q or small p, after the bracket. It is not necessary to write. Because the value, when you use these two types of notations, remains same. So hence, you can say as a conclusion, that hence the Poisson bracket remains invariant under canonical transformation. So I hope you have understand everything. So go through this video seriously and you will learn how we can prove that the Poisson bracket remains invariant under the canonical transformation.